Hi everyone, my name is Carmi, and I'm an invertebrate paleontologist at the Florida Museum. To become a paleontologist, you'll probably want to start with a background in either the geological sciences or the biological sciences. But the truth is a little bit closer to needing a combination of the both. Having a background in the geological sciences helps you to understand the past environment in which animals lived a long time ago. And having a biological background helps you understand how those organisms live, so what habitats they preferred, what their bodies might have looked like, and things like that. As a geologist, I tend to think more on, again, the environmental side of things, so thinking about these past environments that the animals lived in. So the geology and the kinds of fossils found here at Devil's Millhopper are a little bit different from the kinds of animals that I usually do research on. So my area of research focuses on clams and snails from a few million years ago, often those found in sites in and around South Florida. Now the sites that we see here in more North Florida, in areas like Devil's Millhopper or further north and maybe Torreya State Park, tend to be older in age. So, you know, several million years older. Florida is basically like a big piece of Swiss cheese. So there's a thin layer of sediments on top that are a little bit younger, but there's all these older rocks that have lots of holes inside. So when the surface starts to wear away, these solution features begin to develop, kind of like the one that you see behind us. But the Devil's Millhopper is a great place to safely observe a sinkhole, rather than trying to wait for one to open up on a highway or in a housing development or another location. So one of the big questions that I get a lot as a paleontologist working in a museum is, why are museum collections important? Why do they matter? And how do they help us study past life on Earth? I use collections a lot for my research, so it's nice to have a large database of comparative material and learning how to identify the animals that I'm finding in these parts of South Florida. I also like to use them for teaching, so introducing people to basic paleontological concepts, as well as inspiring others to get excited about science and excited about the natural world around them at outreach activities. My question that I get sometimes is how to know if you're looking at a fossil in the field, or how to know if what you're finding is a fossil rather than a rock or a modern organism. Something to do is look for any distinguishing features or ornamentations. So for bivalves or clams, for example, you can look to see if there's a hinge present or different ridges on top of the shell. For vertebrate fossils, a lot of times the bone will be dark and shiny, and if you look at the inside, you can see what look like little holes, or it's not as flat looking. There's a little bit of texture to it. You can also figure out if something is a fossil based on where you find it. So if you find a shell along the beach, for example, it's probably a modern organism. But if you find a shell in one of the creeks or the streams or the rivers, it's probably eroded out of something that's a lot older. I would say that geology is often misunderstood. But I would argue that geology is probably the most important science because it takes a little bit from all the other scientific disciplines, so chemistry, physics, biology, etc., etc. You can just work your way down the list and applies those principles and those theories to the world around you. And as people who are living in the world every day, I don't know if you've noticed, but it's pretty complex to apply theories and principles to a world that's constantly changing around you. So becoming a geologist can help you prevent or mitigate environmental disaster. It can help us develop new types of energy sources for the future. It can help us prepare our coastal communities for changes in sea level or major storm events that are going to occur. And the list kind of goes on and on and on. So geology is really around all of us every day. And having an understanding of those geological principles can not only make us better informed, but it can also make us better citizens because we'll know how to take care of the world around us. And paleontology falls within the wider umbrella of that, because understanding our past, so our past animals, both vertebrates and invertebrates, can help us understand them in the present and how to plan for how those communities of animals might change in the future.